London, the Organisation of Islamic Cooperation, OIC, on Thursday mounted a veiled attack on a Muslim summit in Malaysia shunned by Saudi Arabia, saying such gatherings would weaken Islam. Leaders of Muslim nations, including Turkey and Qatar, attended the summit in Kuala Lumpur, which analysts say is aimed at rivaling the OIC, a 57-member pan-Islamic body headquartered in the Saudi city of Jeddah. Malaysian Prime Minister Mahathir Mohamad dismissed those concerns in a phone call with Saudi Arabia's King Salman, insisting the summit was not intended to create a new bloc. Hosting a summit of Muslim leaders, Malaysia's Prime Minister Mahathir Mohamad bemoaned the state of Islam and defended the meeting that has been shunned by Saudi Arabia and criticized for undermining the bigger Organisation of Islamic Cooperation, OIC. Divisions in the Muslim world were self-evident as only about 20 countries sent leaders or delegations to the Kuala Lumpur summit, though all 57 members of the OIC had been invited. The Saudi king's refusal to attend, and the late withdrawal of Pakistan from the event had left the hosts scrambling to soothe sensitive relations. In welcoming remarks, Mahathir said the Kuala Lumpur summit was meant to understand why Islam, the Muslims and their countries were, in a state of crisis, helpless and unworthy of this great religion. It was unclear to what extent the leaders would discuss major geopolitical crises afflicting the Muslim world, ranging from the age-old disputes in the Middle East and Kashmir, to the conflicts in Syria and Yemen, through to the plight of Rohingya Muslims in Myanmar and the alleged persecution of Uyghur Muslims in China's Xinjiang region. Mahathir said the summit, which will end on Saturday, should address the world's perceptions of Islam, the rise of Islamophobia, the decline of the Islamic civilization and reforms in governance needed by Muslim nations. "We are not discriminating or isolating anyone," he said in his welcome speech, watched on by leaders including Turkish President Tayyip Erdogan, Iranian President Hassan Rouhani and Qatari Emir Sheikh Tamim bin Hamad Al Thani. "We are attempting to start small, and if these ideas, proposals and solutions are acceptable and prove workable, we hope to take it up to the larger platform for consideration." Turkey's President Tayyip Erdogan struck a similar tone. "We will have the opportunity to talk freely about our issues, from Islamophobia to terrorism, divisions, internal fights ravaging our region, and sectarian and ethnic conflicts," Erdogan told the summit. The OIC had said it was against the interests of the Islamic community to convene meetings outside the Saudi-based organization, which has for decades acted as the collective voice of the Muslim world. Both Mahathir and Erdogan have been frustrated by the OIC's past record of hand-wringing and failure to take firm action in support of Muslim causes. Without mentioning the OIC by name, Erdogan said the biggest problem that platforms bringing the Islamic world together faced was a lack of implementation. "If we still haven't made any progress regarding the Palestinian cause, if we still can't stop the exploitation of our resources, if we still can't say, stop to the fragmentation of the Muslim world over sectarianism, that's why. Pakistan wants to become part of the solution and not part of the problem." Information Minister Firdaus Ashiq Aiwan told reporters in Islamabad. The President of Iran called for Muslim countries to cooperate in fighting U.S. economic terrorism at the opening of a summit aimed at tackling the Islamic world's woes. Please subscribe our YouTube channel Listen News here. If you like the video, please like, comment and share the video.